Namaste friends, myself Dr. Mohanty Shenoy, working as consultant endocrinologist in Trivandrum. I welcome you all to the endocrine awareness discussion series. Today I am discussing with you a least discussed topic called thyroid cancer. What is thyroid cancer? Thyroid cancer is an increasingly diagnosed entity in the last 10 years. Primarily because of increased awareness of that condition as well as of early pickup due to familial origins of the same. The coastal areas of Kerala like the Chavara belt has been associated with radiation outcome, and there are various reasons by which our population is susceptible to this, and there may be a chance of overdiagnosis because of the nodule which get diagnosed by early FNAC. The main symptoms of thyroid cancer can be the hoarseness of the voice, of the swelling of the neck, as well as the compressive symptoms. Some thyroid cancers may not have any symptoms and may only be diagnosed by FNAC. The ultrasound scan is a very sensitive marker by which you can diagnose thyroid malignancy. Along with it, we have got a fine needle technique of thyroid FNAC, which can help you to identify the pathology of the condition. Endocrinologist deals with thyroid cancer with a team of experts like the surgeon as well as nuclear medicine doctor. The surgery can itself be curative in 100% and may be require extensive surgery in the initial stage itself. Thyroglobulin is a marker for the thyroid surgery outcome, and whole body iodine scan may be required in a majority of cases when we have suspicion of residual tumors. Annual follow-up is necessary because once thyroid cancer is diagnosed, it can be managed by lifelong suppression of the TSH values to less than 0.1 in many cases. In some doubtful cases, we will require nuclear studies like FDG PET. After surgery, there is also a coordinated work between the nuclear medicine, the thyroid surgeon, as well as the endocrinologist. Because before instituting long-term thyroxine therapy, we need to ensure that there is no residual area left after surgery. This is done by a whole body iodine scan, and recurrences and residual area can be diagnosed by a thyroglobulin levels which are written on the serum. So even if you are diagnosed with thyroid cancer, the good news is that there is a good chance that the surgery may itself be curative, and the 5-year residual outcome of survival is also high. So vigilance is necessary and we have to monitor them, because ultimately thyroid awareness is the one which helps you to come across these barriers. I welcome you all to our initiative and help us to identify more problems by writing to us on endocrineawareness@gmail.com. Thank you all for the kind listening.